Hello, everyone. It's a great honor to be here today. Thank you so much, Margot. Of course, Your Excellency is the ambassadors of Germany and Slovakia and their, of course, missions and respected guests. First of all, I have to thank everybody for the insightful information that you've shared so far. It's been very interesting to learn from each of your perspectives. So in the next few minutes, actually, I'm going to share with you some interesting and I would say even crucial innovations and technologies that help cities adapt and cope with climate change challenges in the light, of course, of the World Cities Day and the 26th UN COP. Our planet obviously is facing, you know, increasing events that have direct relations to climate change, the floods, the storms, extreme heat, the raising of the sea level. And while there are countless of actions that are to take, the use of technology can support us in dealing with this crisis, and especially in the urban space. Now, I'm about to share a few technologies and innovation. I own a business consulting firm that I work with technologies and help them go in the global market. That would give me the ability to share some of these today. I'd like to begin with a topic, with a company that addresses a topic that was raised here earlier. The company name is Nostromo, and they're basically cooling global warming and accelerating renewable energy in a very interesting way. So the problem, if we'll start with that, is of course that a huge portion of the peak demand in the energy grid is driven by air condition. Especially in hot climates, energy used for cooling buildings, you know, has doubled over the past two decades, and it accounts for a tenth of the global electricity consumption in the next three decades. So air conditioning is set to advance to one of the top drivers for global energy demand all over the world, and that's very disturbing. So what they did, the solution, Nostromo found out an available way to deal with the growing problem, ice. Now I want to ask you, did you know that ice can store energy and help companies reduce the carbon footprint in the process? I didn't know that. But apparently Nostromo's sustainable energy storage solution enabled commercial and industrial buildings to become large-scale energy assets. So this benefits building owners, the electric grid, and ultimately paves the way for a carbon-free future. So the revolutionary technology, which I'll show you in a minute, just to so you get a feel of how it looks, they called it the Nostromo Ice Brick. It's basically a modular thermal cell that can fit any building as an extension, and it is 10 times more efficient in its energy density per square meter than any other available solution. Now, let me just show you how it looks so it will make some sense. If you see, this has been placed on top of commercial buildings to be able to help and support the cooling system. So basically it stores energy during off-peak and supports solar hours and uses it for cooling during peak hours. Nostromo solution is safe, you can see it, it's in the building, it looks good, it's clean, it's cost-effective and highly modular, making it ideal for installation and in existing and commercial buildings and industrial facilities. They're currently operating in the US West Coast and expanding, and you can find Shell as among their partners, and they're just recently started to be traded in the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. The next company I want to show you, which definitely revolutionizes its space, it's called Mobility Insights. They actually have used artificial intelligence software as a service solution, addressing the problem of traffic congestion. So the problem, as we know, the traffic is leading contributor to increasing pollution levels in cities. In the United States, transportation accounts for one third of energy related emissions, according to the Environmental Protection Agency. So this pollution is taking a serious toll on the environment, resulting in dramatic environmental changes that affects the weather and more. The solution that they find at Mobility Insights is to develop managing solution that managing transportation network. You can see this sensor. So basically they have their applications provide policy makers, transportation planners and traffic controllers with the advanced intelligence mobility system driven by real time mobility analytics, predictions, optimizations, algorithm, and all of those help to create the actionable insights. So the system enables road authorities to pinpoint future bottlenecks and take primitive actions that reduce road congestion and harmful carbon emissions. They serve as a traffic management center, unlock the grid and reducing time on the road. And with that pollution, they currently operate in Israel and Florida. And last but not least is, let's go to my hometown, Tel Aviv, Israel. I want to talk to you about what the city council is doing. So Tel Aviv City Council, among, you know, it's planning and investing resources to enable the city to deal with climate change challenges, such as using data management for better adaption to climate related circumstances, using natural based solutions and more. But one of the main activities which I find really interesting is the co-owner of a place called City Zone, which serves as a living lab. So the City Council basically presents the challenges that they have to City Zone, and City Zone is able to help them find an innovative technological solutions on demand, I would say. And I think that's a very interesting asset that can support the city in finding specific technological solutions to raising issues. And before I finish, I want to share with you that a few days ago, the State of Israel published a special and I think first time ever report about its readiness for climate change challenges. And the results were very disturbing and concerning. They mentioned that 84% of the public bodies in Israel, among them, of course, the majority of the cities, are not prepared to deal with climate change. And the outcome could be lethal, as we know, and harm the economy, health, transportation, and many other aspects. So Israel is only one example, but I'm sure many cities and countries out there that are not prepared to deal with climate change challenges. So as someone who works with smart city technologies on a regular basis, I would like to use this stage and call you as much as you can to utilize the power of innovation to respond and fight climate change challenges. Use innovative solutions, support your innovators, enable the formation of such solution, and give it the highest priority for our children and for our own future. Thank you, Margot. Thank you so much for having me, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the discussion. Thank you.
Yeah, I was just getting my camera back on. Thank you so much, Lirone.